Welcome everybody to a rather wet woodland camping experience. I've been wandering around trying to find somewhere to pitch. Basically what we've got is this dog tarp. This is literally our shelter for tonight. Obviously we've got a bivvy as well, but this is our shelter. So we're gonna have to kind of wing it a bit and see how we get on. So my head's gonna be around about here. Oh. Oh, well, you can tell we're experts at this. That's a dead bit of a branch there. So we'll secure that there. I think I'm going to have to loosen that one over there off somehow, because my head's going to be there. So we are kind of covering. There's a bigger, stronger branch over here. So it's quite loose cord. It's not too tight, so I don't think we're going to hurt. I don't think we're going to hurt the trees. And then hopefully we can tighten this one up and that gets this over my head. All right, so we've just got this bit here that we can just do with, because it doesn't really have to be perfect. It just has to keep the worst of the rain off, and I think I have a very, very long piece of line here that I brought with me, and then this piece here, we can probably put this piece, use one peg. It could probably do with coming this way just a little bit more, to be honest, there. And then we've probably got a dry-ish area under there. I mean, you know, the tarp isn't super tight, but it doesn't have to be super tight. You know, it just has to be enough that it just keeps as much rain as possible off us. It needs a little modification, but I've got Lizzie in a Ziploc a Ziploc bag. It does need a little playing with here and there. It's not perfect because she's so small that her back legs actually sort of go, it's too big for her, that down there, so like I said, you don't need a footprint, but you know, obviously something, you know, can be useful just as a little extra protection. It's getting quite dark now. That's all electrical stuff there. And then in here, so that bag, that stuff sack, that has literally everything rolled up in it, is going to come down this way. So I think I'm going to be undercover quite a lot. But basically what I've got is here, is that's everything wrapped up in there. As you can see, we have one bed. So in here, this is a real test for down. So in this bag here, what we've got somewhere. That's my tea staff, so we'll put that in there. Lizzie. Toilet paper, that can go in there. Wait there, Lizzie. Oh. I should have, yeah. Here. I wouldn't take it on a long trip, but for this, we will get some air pumped into that. That's breakfast, that's dinner, that's crackers, that's starting to get wet, so that can stay out there. That's electrical stuff. We'll put that in there. That's my warm jacket, so we'll put that. Lassie was carrying Liz's stuff, so that's Liz's stuff there. So that's slowly starting to inflate. So we'll get that inflated, and then once it's inflated, we'll get me in, and then we'll concentrate on Lizzie. Right, so we've got some degree of dryness here. I kind of complicated it by bringing the kindergarten with me again. I think this is probably about her limit, to be honest with you. I'm a little bit, I thought that was, is that fully inflated? That we'll have to get air into it. That's really not, it's either got a leak or it just didn't, I didn't inflate it enough. I'm not quite sure which. We will have to see. Look, I think we need to just get undercover, to be honest now. It's not freezing. I've got dry socks at the moment, so I would like to keep them that way, to be honest. You sometimes get, yeah, I haven't quite worked out what I'm going to do with my clothes and such like yet, and boots and things, but we'll just put that there for now. I think we just need to get, we're dry, so that's good. I think I'm probably, unless that rain stops soon, I think I'm going to
close the bivy bag.
Luckily, we've got some degree of dryness here. So that's Liz's bed. So let's just get that under there. We've got coats and things in here. So I've got a dry jacket for her, and a secondary dry jacket. So let's get that under there. And then I don't know what she's wearing, whether that's wet or dry, but I've got another something in there for tomorrow for her. So once we get her out of this, then she's okay. Oh, Lizzie, it's not the absolute ideal thing, and like I said, it needs a little bit of work on the bottom because her legs were catching that bit down there. Let's get her out of that, because it's a little bit damp. So we'll put that towel inside. To be honest, that thing kept her pretty dry. And this is keeping quite a bit of rain off, not all. I'm probably going to start to get wet. And obviously hypothermia will be setting in, you know, in a minute. You know, we're obviously going to freeze and die here. Some people, they recommend a hot water bottle. I recommend a Yorkshire Terrier. So let's get her dry thing on, and then we'll get her, we'll get her in, inside. Oh, Lizzie. All right, there you go. So you can go under there now. Okay, now obviously I'll have to keep an eye on her. Her clothes I'm going to put there. I think boots I'm going to turn upside down. I don't know if that's a good thing or not, but I'm going to turn the boot. That's the jet boil, so we might get a cup of tea. I don't know. Okay, all right. Well, my hands are wet. I need to duck under here and just sort of unwind and get out of this damp air a bit. So there's nothing really out here. My waterproof jacket's there, but it's inside out. That's there. So I think I just need to get undercover. Okay. All right. Well, I think it's going to be dry biscuits this evening, unless we get a change in the weather. I think I'm going to duck under and let the warmth warm me up a little bit, and you know, and try and hopefully dry out a bit. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to have, I don't know whether I'm going to have my meal. I've had quite a few crackers and I've got some sweet biscuits. You know, maybe I have the meal, but it's not ideal. It's not ideal weather. I think the jet boil will go there. You can see that there. We've got Lizzie sort of on the sleeping bag. You can't see her because she's under there quite well. She's very cozy there. It's going to be interesting if she needs the loo or something in the night. Anyway, I'll try and make our tea. Okay, well, I just about managed to get a signal for the weather. I can't get a signal for anything else. Nothing else comes through, but I can get the weather. So it's going to rain until about midnight. It's not hammering it down. It's kind of just a steady, unpleasant rain. But it's not hammering it down. It's just one of those persistent type rains. And the tarp up there, whilst it's not really, it's luckily keeping the bits dry, which was kind of how I was trying to rig it. It's kind of keeping the bits dry that need to be kept dry. And because there's so many trees, they were supposed to be this storm Andromeda or whatever it was coming through. But I think it's calmed down, and down here in this little wooded area, we're quite sheltered here anyway, but the trees aren't blowing. So, you know, even though it's pitched quite high, probably, maybe, you know, maybe would have been better to kind of had it a bit more as a lean-to, which was kind of my original, that was kind of my original idea, was to do like a lean-to. And then when I saw all the trees, that was kind of too good an opportunity to pass up, really, of, you know, trying to be a little bit clever and, you know, try and get a different kind of pitch going, get a really high tap pitch with my hand where it is. I can feel rain on my hand there, but where my head is, the top of the tap there, you know, is kind of, it's just enough. It's just, like I said, luckily I got it in just the right place. For once in my life, I've actually done something right for once. And it's pretty much keeping my head dry. The top of the bivy, you know, is very wet there. But hopefully it protects us. I think it will. That's the other one. That's the other one there. She's just out for the count. Anyway, I'm gonna turn the GoPro off. I'm gonna enjoy my tea. And then I think I might try and have a pee. And the tarp every now and again has a little pee as well. And like I said, it's supposed to stop raining at midnight. So that's another 8 hours. It would just be nice not to be raining when we pack up. That would just make things a little bit easier. I brought this one with me. I don't really like it. It's just not the easiest of things to drink from. But what it is good at is collapsing. And that's useful when you don't have so much room in your pack and, you know, weight's not so much of an issue. And you just want to collapse it down and stick it in a edge of a pocket or, you know, in your pack or something. Anyway, I think I need to try and have a pee. And then we're going to duck back under cover. I'll bring the GoPro under with me so you can kind of have a little look. you can have a little bit of a look. But that's camp. I'll try and if I get you under the bed covers. That's right. I think the female rate of viewing has actually surprisingly increased. It was about 0%, and then it was 0.1%, and then it was 0.2%. I think it's about 2% now. So anyway, we're a dirty old man here. Don't worry. Anyway, back to the subject of camping. Welcome to our evening. We have a minor problem. It's not a major problem, but we have a minor problem. And that's my nose. I was feeling really, really tired. And I did the bivy app. And because it was raining at that time, I did the bivy app, you know, completely. And very, very quickly, very, very quickly, my left nostril started to get bunged up. I could feel it, and then I could feel myself slowly start, you know, that first hyperventilation thing. And I was starting to feel very warm. So I've got out of the quilt. So I'm on the mat, and I've just pushed the quilt to one side because I felt like I was getting a bit warm. Because to be fair, it's a 0 degree quilt, centigrade, 0 centigrade, and I'm not sure what the temperature is. It's probably about 12 degrees, something like that. And I think if I was in a tent and I didn't have the bivy, then I think 0 degrees would be okay, because I was certainly fine in Scotland. And whilst we had one cold night up there, generally it was quite mild, and I never had a problem. But I think being in the bivy, it started to get very warm. So I'm out of the bivy. This lump that you can see down here is not that lump. Is Lizzie, so you can kind of see that she's okay. She's fine. You kind of get the gist. I've got my underwear on. Keep showing me underwear off. So, any tips, suggestions, recommendations for a bunged up nose and how not to hyperventilate? I have done it up before. I mean, I'm mostly fine when I've got the mesh closed up. So I will try closing the mesh up, which just gives you a little bit of an airway. It's about 3 inches of mesh there. So, and you can do it up in such a way that you can have half or three quarters or all or none zipped up and the mesh open, you know, as much as you want. I remembered this light. I brought this light with me this time. Good job I did, because this head torch, it doesn't, you can't really expect miracles from it, you know, to be fair, but full power, I don't think you'd get. I might have to do a test and see how long full power lasts with it, but I reckon you'd only get an hour, because I've had it on full power and medium power and low power, you know, only for a couple of hours, and then it dropped from, there's three levels, there's low, medium, high, and the high cuts off, and then you've got the two levels. Within a couple of hours of a mixture of low, medium and high, and not on high very much, not that much, I don't think, it cuts off the high, but then at least it's supposed to then give you enough time, or plenty of time, in low and medium. So it's like the high is probably going to give you maybe an hour, I guess, and then it will drop down to give you enough time on the other two settings. But yeah, I was feeling really tired, and I started to think, okay, I'm gonna try and fall asleep, because I was nearly falling asleep. And as I say, my nose just started to bung up very quickly, and I started to get very warm, and it was very uncomfortable. So I'm going to put my head down again, and we'll kind of see what happens. But you know, you can see you can see our setup there. We really are out here. We haven't gone and stayed in a hotel or something like that. Anyway, it's supposed to, from the forecast, it was supposed to stop raining from about midnight anyway, and then maybe to start again in the morning at some point or other. So I'll have another look. Oh, actually, I was able to get a tiny bit of a signal for the weather. The weather outside is frightful. Dee 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 dee. Da 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 da. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Okay, well, so we did manage to get an update. So from now until 5 o'clock, it shouldn't rain anymore now until 5 o'clock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock. 5 o'clock, there's 90% chance of rain. 6, 7 o'clock, 50% chance of rain. And then it's showing not raining until a light shower at 11, and then thunder showers at 12. Well, we'll pack up. We'll have breakfast and pack up. But it's kind of a good test. You know, to see how I would be, you know, closed up in a bivvy. And it's a bit of a, I have to say, it's a bit of a concern. It's a bit of a concern. If you're having an emergency, maybe you've got to sort of, you know, open like a tiny, tiny bit if it's raining and you're stuck out in emergency, and just have your nose sticking out or something, I don't know. Or maybe I've got an aqueous spray, but I never remember to use the bloomin' thing. So maybe I ought to use that regularly, and maybe that would help open the passages up. So maybe that would help, I don't know. Or maybe a decongestant, maybe that would help. But it was really not a very nice thing. I always had the strange thing at night when the torch is shining on me and I'm filming myself, that there's going to be a great monster going to come and grab me from behind. Well, mind if she was a 21-year-old blonde, I don't think I'd be so lucky. Anyway, we better get some sleep, and I think I'm better off out here by myself, to be honest. I think it's cheaper, less asshole. All right, well, I'm going to settle back down again, and maybe see you later on. I don't know if we survive the night, but we'll get through the night one way or another. At least it's not going to rain anymore now until the early hours, so I can leave the little vent thing open. But like I said, it was closing it up that was a problem.
I don't think I like confined spaces. And I've always been okay with this one, with this bivy. That was why I like this bivy, but I've always had this mesh panel here. And like I said, I think also just a combination of being a little bit too warm probably, you know, didn't help over. So anyway, living, you know, we're learning. That's what we're doing. That's the whole point of coming out. And, you know, yeah, we could just use a tent, but then we don't learn something if we just use a tent all the time. So, or a trail star or something. So, and I have to admit, I nearly only brought the bivy, but when I saw the forecast and that there was a lot of rain, that's when I brought the tarp with me, just to give me something over the head, because I didn't want to, be, you know, confined quarters, you know, too much. So I'm kind of glad I brought that. At least it's given me some, you know, a bit of protection. You've always got to have your protection. I got one track mind, don't I? Anyway, all right, well, I'm going to carry on camping, as they say. Hopefully we've got Tracky working this time. All right, see you later.